the brother on the left.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Khalid Hussein and I'm working as an electrical engineer in ETS one group of companies. My question is, does Islam permit media? Because during the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was no any means of mass communication as mentioned by you. So could you please justify by quoting any of the surahs or any sahih hadith? Thank you.
The brother has posed the question that at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was no mass media. So does Islam permit media? Can you quote a Quranic verse or hadith? Brother, point to be noted. As far as ibadah is concerned, what is mentioned is fard. This is the law of the Sharia. In other things, in the mamlaat, in day-to-day life, what is mentioned as haram is haram, everything else is halal. For example, pork is haram, haram, alcohol is haram. What is not mentioned is halal. I'm asking you a question. Is there any hadith or Quranic verse which says that you can have mango? Is there any hadith? So will you say mango is haram? So in terms of worship, what is mentioned is fard. Only do that, nothing else. In terms of how to lead a life, what is mentioned, haram is haram, everything is halal. So tomorrow you'll ask me, brother Zakir, why are you eating mango? And I love mango, huh? Because I come from India and I'm proud of my country and I'm proud of the mango of my country. So first of all, you should give me contrary a proof, a hadith or a Quranic verse saying media is haram. Yet, brother, I will give you proof. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he did? He dictated letters to non-Muslim kings, to the kings of Abyssinia, king of Yemen, of Persia, asking them, quoting the verse of the Quran of Surah Al-Imran chapter 3, verse number 64, قُلْ يَهَلَ الْكِتَابِ say, O people of the book, تَعَلَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلْمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَ بَيْنَكُمْ come to common terms as in us and you. Which is the first term? Allah نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا that we associate our partners with him. وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْدٌ بَعْدًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دِنِ اللَّهِ that we erect not among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا if then they turn back. فَقُلُوا شَدُوا see bear witness بِأَنَّ مُسْلِمُونَ that we are Muslim bowing our will to Allah. He dictated letters and he sent them on horses. Today's little Mercedes car or what do I want to call jet planes in different directions asking them to accept Islam. That was media that time. Imagine dictating letters, after dictating, arranging horsemen to go in different directions. He utilized the media to the best of his ability, what he had. Wallah, today if Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive, I feel he would have used the media to the best of his ability. But within the purview of the Islamic Sharia, not utilizing anything which is haram. Haram things should not be used, but what is halal? Like a knife can be used for good purpose and bad purpose. So knife per se is not haram. So media per se is not haram, though majority of the things on the media are haram. What we have to do is use it in a halal way. Turn the tables over. Within the purview of the Islamic Sharia, utilize in a halal way. So at least we can testify to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that inshallah we tried our little bit what we could to convey the message. Because our job is to convey the message. Allah says, فَذَكِّرْنَ مَنْ تَمُذَكِّرِ our job is to deliver the message. Giving hidayah is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hope that answers the question.
Jazakallah.
The next question from Tanveer Khan. For giving the answers to Hindus or non-Muslim media, should we have to read Gita, Bible, etc.?
The brother posed that to give the answer to the Hindu or the media, should we read the Gita or the Bible? It is not fard in Islam. It is mustahab, you can read. Because this is what Allah says, the verse I quoted earlier, in the earlier answer. Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 64 says, تَعَلَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلْمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا بَيْنَكُمْ come to common terms as between us and you. Now how will we come to common terms until we don't know what the scripture says? So in this context, we should read the scripture. It's not fard. I feel it is mustahab. It is one of the strategies shown by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our Prophet. When a prophet said, Balligu anni walo aya, propagate even if you know one verse, it's a hadith of Sahih Bukhari. It continues and says, there is no problem if you quote the scriptures of the Ahl-e Kitab. So quoting the scriptures of the other religion is one of the techniques shown by a prophet and mentioned in the Quran. So if you can do this, it is the best. But you need not become hafiz of the Bible. or Hafiz of the Veda or Hafiz of the Gita. You should know the verses which are important for doing Dawah. Should not waste your time doing Hifz. You can do Hifz of the Quran. Not waste your time. And neither am I the Hafiz of the Bible, neither of the Quran. I would like to be, but I'm not. Neither of the Vedas, neither of the Bhagavad Gita. But I know those verses of the Veda which are required for Dawah. Those verses of the Bible which are quoted by Christian missionary. So you think I know more than the Christian missionary, which inshallah, alhamdulillah, I know. But I have mastered this art, which you know Sheikh Didat, mashallah. He's the person who inspired me. May Allah grant him Jannah. He was a great inspiration for thousands of youngsters, including me. So the thing is that you need not waste time, but you should know that portion which is required for Dawah and to convey to them the message of Islam, as Quran says, which are similar things. If you do this, inshallah, it will help you to convey the message of Islam.
I understand there are lots and lots of questions, but we have a time to keep, a deadline to complete. So we'll just